Okay. Yeah, this is what I'm expecting. Okay, from that time. Okay. Now you tell me if I have multiple applications are there, how I can select it? Now here they have given me option application logs, all those things I can select. Okay. Is there any location and specific path I would like to monitor? Means how many paths I can select? You tell me here. Only one, right? Guys, only one path I can select. Okay. If I have like application logs, means these are Windows logs. These are performance of the Windows only. If Active Directory means that Windows Active Directory logs only. Okay. Means like if it is a Windows Active Directory server. Okay. If I have an application server. Okay. Then I'll select it. What if I have multiple application servers on the same machine? Like I have hosted my multiple websites like apps dot my company name dot com and hr dot my company name dot com, because very small applications. I have installed two applications on the same machine. Will it be possible for me to, okay, select the logs from both servers at the same instance of time? Nagendra, are you getting?
Yes, I'm following. Yes.
Yes. So only one directory you will be able to select, or one log file you will be able to select. But okay, if you have multiple, okay, then again you have to install the universal forwarder and you again have to select the file here. Okay, you won't select that time all these things. You will select only the which other path you have to monitor, and you will be sending it to the other location. Okay, you will follow the same steps, whatever it is there, right? All other steps remain. But which logs you are forwarding, this path is there, right? Where the application server logs are getting stored. Okay, if you have multiple app servers, usually what they do is, here they have given one, that's okay with that. But if you have multiple application servers, okay, then you have to use multiple collectors you should have. Correct, right? So the software is one only, but the agents working for it are multiple. Okay, for Windows application logs, one thing will be working inside, okay, collecting all the logs from there, okay, and processing it, and whatever the thing you have using it, right, that will be same. Logically they are one, but physically they are one location only they are installed, because one big folder will be there in Splunk. You will get all the different indexes within the same folder. Same way, okay, the software is only one location only. Forwarder will be there here like this only, like forwarder. If I go my computer, okay, and if I select C, and if I select program files, I will have Splunk forwarder only one. That is one only. Inside etc, okay, I will have multiple, not etc,
It
think bin or somewhere.
is
Yeah, bin you take. Okay, these bins you will have multiple scripts. Okay, something will be like here monitoring, right? I am doing sysmon and all those things. Okay, same way I'll get one more thing called as application server path. Something here, WMI path, different paths I have, right? One more path it will get added. So this is the, as long as it will be collector will be one, but the agent in them, right, collector which is working, this file will be working differently to bring the logs. Okay, and through the same pipe only it will be go, through network cable only it will go. Okay, but you have to make sure that they are coming to one location and they are sending by different files, path files. Okay, that's what my whole intention, why I have written this path.
In case the server is hosted with multiple applications, that much agents needs to be installed now.
See, that many number of times you have to use your universal forwarder. Got it right. Every time for the new application installs, there is no option for you to select multiple path folders. So you have to again install, next, you have to come to this location, and then you have to select again one more path folder, and then click next and proceed further. Okay. So if you have only one thing means yes, this is okay. But if you have multiple Apaches, then it is not useful. Like in the Apache itself, multiple websites are there. Okay, only one website is there, I don't have any issues. In Apache, I have multiple websites. So multiple logs I have to collect in different, because each web server I might be using different index value. Okay, one I'll be telling that Amazon.com, one I'll be telling HR.Amazon.com, one I'll be telling it as like payroll.Amazon.com, something like that. Okay, so each website I need every time when I install, I need a separate, okay, path to be selected so that it will go and create a new path file here from where it has to take it. Got it?
Yes. Only path needs to be mentioned with same agent.
Yes. The agent itself. No, that's why I told different. See, who will collect the logs? Agent only is collecting. The path is only collecting. Correct, right? The agents are working. That's what I'm telling. Okay. So different logs, different agents will be working. Here one agent is working, right? Here, this path. Okay. Here this path. As long as the logs are coming here, someone is working for it. Okay. So that's what I said. Just remember that logically it is only one thing, but physically they are actually one thing, but logically they are multiple parts. Okay. Just remember that. No one will ask in, you are not admin also, but I'm just giving you clarification that you consider all operating system logs are considered as one way and they send it. Okay. As one collection point and send it. Why I have given this also, I'll explain you. Okay. In later point of time, this is the one context you remember. And the first log collection has happened. Okay. Now we will add the context. Okay. Now what is meant by context? Context means like putting the information, like giving which logs are these? These logs are belongs to. Yes, these logs are Windows logs, correct? Right? Am I correct or not? These are belongs to the Windows logs. Okay. Usually, for any Windows logs, forget about
this one, back one.
Huh? Yeah, go ahead.
I will give some noise on your back end.
Now?
Yes, clear.
Okay. Oh, that, okay, someone is, okay. Okay, that is not right. But it is not my wind sound, right? Because I switched on my fan. It is not that, right?
No, not that one.
Okay. Fine. No issues. Okay. What I was telling, I forgot something.
adding content Windows.
Adding like context to the Windows. Correct. Okay, got it. Okay, so now while you are correcting the logs, okay, whatever the critical information logs you have decided to collect, you are collecting it. That is the first step. It is done. Okay, it can be agent or agentless. You are sending the logs, okay, from the machine. Okay, now you have something called as aggregator. What's its main task is? It collects whatever the taking all the logs, right? Okay, from different locations. Okay, like now I will say it as this is where it is universal forwarder, correct? Right? WF, UF. Consider just. Everything is there in universal forwarder only. Okay. Now, whatever you have taken those logs, okay, and you will add context, okay, to them. Okay, say for example, okay, context means what? Okay, the logs, whatever you are taking, it needs some meaningful information to be put. Okay, these are Windows logs, these are Apache logs. That before you send it to the indexer, that information like your source, I mean like the IP address from where it is generating, so all that information, you might be required to add some context to those logs. Okay, so for example, if it is a failure logs, okay, example, okay, so it will put under something called as like something like the critical kind of thing. Okay, you put some context. It is a security logs only, but it is like adding some extra, what do you say, not adding some extra, like grouping of similar set of logs, okay, under one category. Okay, so say for example, all these are security logs, so which is the source type? This belongs to this source. Okay, this belongs to this host name, this belongs to the, all that information you are going to put it. Okay, that is like adding some context, meaning to your logs. Okay, now you will put all that information, and then what you will do, you will send these logs from here. Okay, this entire logs is combined at one pipe through internet cable. Okay, from this machine inside, you collect, you installed wherever it is there, right? Then you'll start sending those logs to the other external world. Okay, you sent it. Okay, where you received it, guys? Where you receive it? You receive it in some location. Sorry, some location in the SIM. Correct, right? Somewhere it is. I say this is the network. Okay, that's what I know. This is a network. In the network, somewhere the SIM is there. SIM is there. Okay. This is the SIM. Okay. Now this is okay. This PC is in India. And this SIM is in US. Okay. Now what I want to do is, let me put this under India. Yeah, that's better. Okay. Now what I'll do is, I have similar kind of setup. Okay. Some agents are sending the logs in not in India, but in Singapore also. Okay. Now, here I given one PC, but you consider like 1,000 PCs are there. Okay, remember that. 1,000 PCs are there. Remember that. Okay. Now, what I'll do is, I am connecting this from here to the other SIM. Okay, connected. Unfortunately, what happened? The internet disconnection happened either at the here or here, any one location. Say for example, here only the internet connection, in India only it happened. Okay, in India only happened. The possible scenarios is, once the SIM gets disconnected, okay, usually our Splunk forwarder will have some storage capacity by default. Storage capacity will be there. Some memory is allocated for it. Maybe like 1 GB or something like that. Say for example, 1 GB, you consider it as, okay. All the logs will be stored here for time being. Okay. Now, what happens if there is no logs coming to this location, okay, for certain amount of time? They also come to know about, these guys have come to know that internet is down. They can't also do anything. Okay. But what it is going to get impacted? if it is like 1 GB is the space for one, say for example, from this site, 1000 systems are there, each system will have 1 GB of data, okay, is the capacity where they can store the logs temporarily, because net is gone, so till they can store temporarily. But after like 1 GB gets filled, maybe half an hour or something happened, the logs are filled till 1 GB, old logs automatically gets cleared because the capacity itself 1 GB in that connector or log collection point or forwarder. Okay, now example I'm giving. Okay, so now this got out of your hand. Now what is happening inside? 1 GB old logs are getting cleared, means what is that? Old logs, if it get clears, will it be possible to recollect them?
No.
No chance. Correct, right? So you are losing the critical data, either from compliance point of view, or also from the SIM point of view, security point of view. Correct, right? So it is very dangerous. Okay. This might be the condition where we are not reachable from here to there, or they are not able to reach from here to here because of the internet connection down here or here. Okay, that is the issue. So that's why they will keep one more server in this particular site. Okay, that is called as broker here. Okay, it will be like some 5 TB or 10 TB of something, 10 TB or something. Okay, like which can store the organization capacity of data for one day. Usually our organization data might be like log data might be 10 TB or something like that for a day. So for 1 hour, it is maximum takes like 800 or 600 GB something. That's not an issue. We will keep it here. Okay. So now the disconnection happened here or in the organization itself, in India location itself. Okay, now my office doesn't have internet, but my logs are getting stored in my broker. As soon as the internet get restored, either here or here, okay, internet get restored, immediately it sends whatever there in its bucket back to the SIM. So now you didn't lost any data, you didn't lost any events, you didn't lost any information. So now the context remains the same, means you are like compliance side and as well as security side. What happened within that down period of time also, you can actually monitor in the SIM. Is this clear or not, log broker?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, the search is the next part. Okay. Search is the next part. So, database is here in the SIM. Correct, right? I'll just put it here. Some database here. Okay. Let me put it here. One more thing. Oh, God. I am not a designer, but still I'm trying. Okay. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll put it like this. This is the logs. So this is the storage. All your events comes and get stored in the storage. Okay, all events will come and get stored in the storage. Okay, and they will get stored here. Okay, now searching is the next part. See, you take this, and to access the logs in the database, okay, you need some queries to be written. Okay, that is called as searching. Okay, once you start searching, the result of the search you can create them as dashboards also, or reports also. You can use as if you want. Okay, And the thing is, using the searching, okay, you write the search with some conditions, like as I said earlier, the failure login attempts happens, okay, then some condition in a minute, okay, 5 times, then rise an alert. So alert engine will be listening. First event comes, okay, first event comes, failure happened, yes, it makes correlation will has to trigger. So first it will be having one, okay. Now the second event comes, failure attempt from the same machine, then it will become two. Alert engine is tracking this. And three, same again, same thing. Four, again, same thing. Within 1 minute only it happened. Then after that it stopped. It won't trigger alert. Okay. After 1 minute, this three, four happened. Then within 1 minute it didn't trigger. Okay. But after again, like from after becoming fourth, then this 1 minute of time frame expires. This is within 1 minute. 4 times. Okay. Now again, 61st minute, one more event got triggered. So it will calculate from here. The first one. Okay. Then again, two. Okay. Then it is like from this last event to within 1 minute. Okay. If it is like 5 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times happened within this 1 minute, then trigger the event, alert. Okay, alert engine will start working, like whatever the alert engine it is configured, right? Either email has to be sent, report has to be sent, or some SMS has to be sent, all these things you can do, or call has to be initiated with the RSMS are to be sent, or all these things, it will automatically gets taken care. That it's a task of the alert engine. Okay, that is the thing. Is it clear, guys?
Yeah.
Yes, thank you. So now we are almost cleared. Okay, now let's move back to our new thing. Okay, so we were discussing about syslogs. Okay, so today also, because Robin, why I'm taking this Teja and Robin, because these two people also our regular weekend classes, they will be joining. Okay, like whatever we are discussing morning, they are like covering us. They are just little back, somewhere like maybe 3 or 4 classes they are behind to us now, because I covered almost everything. So they can use this time to just anyhow, we have started with these topics, right? This is more applicable for them also now as well. So that's the reason. Okay, so let us move ahead. So syslog. Okay, syslog, let me take once again this log. Okay, sample. I have created where one syslog sample I need. All those things not good. Yeah, take this. I don't know why it is here. Okay, let us put it here. Okay, so this is the syslog. Okay, or you want me to launch like Kali? I don't know, VMX. VMX. No, I don't want. D folder. What else? OS and VMs. Virtual VM test Kali VMX. Okay, by the time we can launch. Okay, it will be open. Okay, so now the important things what you have to remember in a syslog is nothing but any system which is based on Unix or Linux. Remember, guys, one thing I would like to say, that doesn't mean that the Windows operating system, okay, cannot generate syslog or nothing like that. It can generate it, but extra software you have to use it. But any system that is based on, developed on Linux or Unix operating system, okay, any operating system, any device, okay, I will tell you, there are different kinds of systems that provides the syslogs. Okay, the first one, okay, normal operating systems, Windows operating, Linux, like Fedora, Ubuntu to Fedora or Red, those only, right? Red Hat only, Fedora, okay, or normal Unix, any other systems, AIX, IBM, okay, Solaris, all are these different types of systems, okay? They all produce the syslogs, okay? Those are normal operating systems, okay? Like for server applications or end user, as a server, enterprise server or end user computer, like Ubuntu and all, we can use that as server or end user computer, I can use it, okay? Or even Kali machine, Kali Linux, Kali, okay, anything. It can be like a regular day-to-day use, whatever we use as a system, or it is a Linux, or it is a, any server-based applications to install, you can use the same operating system, anything you can use. Or it can be a firewall. Means, don't think that firewall is just a hardware. Any hardware, it requires a software, some operating system, okay? Any hardware, it requires a operating system. Internally, you take IPS, IDS, or antivirus servers, or any hardware if they are giving, or the software, whatever they provide us to install, 90% of them works on, they give it us on Linux, because it is, if you install it on, if you make it ready for one operating system, you can use it for any kind of multiple devices, like firewall, okay, where the logs gets generated OS level or syslogs only, okay, IDS, IPS, okay, those logs also get generated internally, some syslogs. Internally, for the operating system, it requires syslogs, okay? Routers, switches, okay? Then what else? Application, servers, anything, if it is like Kali Linux or anything, those, I don't want to put it, I have already put it. Firewall, IDS, IPS, WAF, web application firewalls, okay. Then what else you can say? Then what else? Where and all we can use any ideas? Where and all we can use syslogs? Wi-Fi routers. Okay. Then printers. Yes, I got some list here. Unix, okay, all those things are. is SAN devices, because they also use storage area network devices. They are also using some operating system inside. So those operating system definitely generates the syslog only. Okay. So these are called as syslogs. Okay. These many devices, they provide syslogs. Okay. Now, syslogs. Yeah. Now I have, I'll take firewall. Okay. The same context you apply. Okay. I have a firewall. I have a firewall. This is a firewall. Okay. Firewall has the operating system. Remember this, guys. Firewall got the operating system. Where the logs will get stored? In a folder. Correct, right? What logs are those? Guys.
OS logs.
System logs.
Syslogs.
Syslogs.
Sys, you should say. Syslog. Okay. These are syslogs. Some etc. You have this particular location logs. You have some folder. In that, it will be. Let me show that. Come on. Okay. Okay. Let me show those logs to you guys. Okay, I'll go to the places for your understanding. I'll go to my computer. There is something called as ECT, AETC. I'll open that. No, it is not etc. Let me open it's etc. Var logs. Okay. If you see here, you have lot of log, different locations, different types of logs are coming. But what are the system logs means? You see, yes, if you click sys logs. Okay. Just opening it now. Okay, now this is a system log. Some timestamp is there. Okay, my machine name is Kali Linux machine. Okay, my machine name is Kali Linux machine. This is the processor which initiated this log. Process which initiated this logs, and this is the message related to the log, the information what it is giving. Okay, now let me close this. Okay, let me log off. I think somewhere log off, anywhere it will be there. Okay, control alt del right. Where I have to. Okay. Let me open this. Okay. I just went outside and came. Okay. Earlier we had only three lines. Okay. Now these many things happened. Anywhere control F login is there. Success. Successfully activated the service. Oh. Sure. For the host name, free desktop, Kali Linux activated. Anywhere, anything. Yeah. From activated service successfully, that is only there. We'll see it later. How we have to. successful activated service, successful activated service. Okay, so just first let's understand the context of the log. Okay, the first part of it is timestamp. Remember that. It should be like this only. Okay, just remember this generic syslog. The second part, and you have to remember one thing. As I said, so many devices are there. Some devices display this pattern, like the how it comes, which one it comes, where it comes. It will be little different from different syslogs, but the type of syslog is the same. Okay, now this is a Kali, that is a Windows machine name, and whatever it is here till here, you are able to view my screen, right?
Yeah.
Okay, this is called as process name, this is called as process ID. Okay, and this is called as system, this is called as system message. Okay, what is the event message? Okay, log message means what it is conveying to us, what happened over here, that is called as it is conveying. Okay. Okay, one more thing, let me try one more time. Reload. Is it anything changed? Okay, I just want to lock it, and I would like to I don't know, my attempts are okay. True. Reload. Control F. Failed. Let me come back. Anywhere. Cluster is layout manager. Manager. I don't know why it is not showing. Anywhere here. Successful activated. Yeah. Log. Give me a second. No, which file? Because it will be system login, login ID. Somewhere it should be there. Let me check. Last one folder is there. I don't know, I am not able to figure it out. Okay, let it be. Why we need to bother when we have the attack logs? I don't know. Okay, so just the things to be remembered. I might be somewhere wrong. Okay, how to look into those syslogs. But okay, let me get back to you guys. Okay, this is the first thing, is the timestamp. Then the host name, then the process. Okay, take one nice big one. Okay, then host name. Okay, and the process name, and the process ID and the message. Okay, are the important things what you should remember first part. Okay, now this messages from system to system might get varied. Second point. Okay, let me take this and put it here. Okay, now I want to monitor the traffic of from the this is system means all your system related, setup related, security related logs will get stored here. Okay, but if you have to monitor the functionality of the firewall, okay, you should look into the traffic logs. Okay, so for that another one folder, different folder. Okay, traffic logs. So the whatever it has happened, main functionality of the, not operating system, main functionality of your firewall will be here. Okay, on top of the operating system, those will be created and will have some logs getting generated. Logs. Okay, those are traffic logs. Okay, that we have seen earlier, right? Once. Okay, those logs will are getting here, and all of them again will be sent to the central server, that is your SIM. Okay, that's why we need like this. Okay, I will tell you. Okay, all the logs which are related to the operating system. Okay, this is firewall one. Okay, and you have one more firewall similar way. Okay, this is one more firewall. From there also syslogs are coming. Okay, those syslogs you will be sending it to the same indexer. Okay, sorry, same source type. Means, boss, this is also firewall related system logs. Firewall related system logs, syslogs. Okay, these logs also firewall related only syslogs. Those are same source type. Okay, but from different source systems. How they are going to get distinguished? Because we have added a context to something called as, okay, from the host name and from, one more thing is from the source IP address. These two things will distinguish source name and IP address. Based on that, even though they are in the same bucket, the event you have added to the log some context, that is from the source, from where which source IP address it came for every event. And you also added some other information, something called as like host name. Okay, we will see all those things, but you remember source type will be the same. Now I want to know the traffic from the traffic logs of this firewall one and this firewall two. What I'll do, I'll be sending them to the source, same source type. Okay, this is the same source type. Okay, this source type is for the syslogs of firewall. Sorry, syslogs for the firewalls. Source type. Syslogs of firewall. Okay, remember this. Okay, now this is traffic logs. Traffic means from which IP it is coming, whether the source port, whether we blocked it or not. Okay, well, I mean like whether the traffic which came to the from the external world to us, whether we blocked it or not, we are allowed it or not. Okay, what happened during that what happened when a request came, did we change any IP addresses of that particular router, I mean like of the source or destination IPs, anything we changed, means kind of NAT kind of thing, anything we have done, all those things will be there. So these are traffic logs. Okay, those are under one source type. Okay, this source type is belongs to traffic log source type. Okay, this source type belongs to syslog source type. If there is any Windows, then Windows logs will be there. Application server installed in that, those are Windows related application logs, which and all will be there, right? Say, for example, I have WAF, two WAFs are there. For each application server, I kept one WAF. Okay, so that time, source type, you will give all those two things under one source type. Okay, for those syslogs. Okay, that is totally different. Not this syslog you'll use. That is WAP, WAF source type you will give. Okay, and for that WAF functionality, traffic related logs. Okay, you will give another source type. For both of them, you will give one. Okay, that is the reason. Okay, there is two multiple websites are there. Okay, that is also I would like to say. This is one website. And this is different website. This is flipkart.com and this is employee, say for example, payroll.flipkart.com, and they have different WAF. This is one WAF and this is one WAF. Okay, for this you will keep same source for syslog same, but okay, you will keep different source type for this app logs, and you will keep different source type for this app log, because those are two different servers which are meant for different websites. That is the reason operating system logs are same. If you take these two belongs to the same Windows operating system, those logs you can monitor same way, but the context will get changed. These are applications which are of two different types. One is for purpose of internal employees, another is for purpose of external. Okay, so that is usually this, it'll be, they won't be so much closer, so, and you won't find so often they are sitting next to each other also, but for your understanding I'm giving this example. Is this clear first of all, or I gave too much? We will see that practically tomorrow. Huh?
Sure.
That means like many of you guys didn't get it. No problem. Tomorrow practically we'll see. Okay, the same things. But at least this thing you are getting it right. Traffic logs, we will be storing it in different source. But all of them belongs to the same index, boss. Say these are all belongs to one index. Like these are all web related logs to these employees, right? Okay, what I want is like all web server, all these things I want to, like from external sources, whatever I'm getting it, right? I would like to keep here under one index. Okay, so for example, Windows servers and all one index, Linux servers and all one index. I might be like my interest, we will see all those things tomorrow, one bucket. Company you will in an organization you will be having multiple indexes, like firewall team, they will have their own index, that's it. Okay, all the devices related to different firewalls, they will be keeping under different source types. Got it, right? Different source type, but they will use one index. Okay, this firewall belongs to DMZ related firewall. For that one different, there might be multiple firewalls, for they are all under one source type. This firewall belongs to perimeter, somewhere some other private network entrance, that one more source type. Okay, but they are under your control, so you'll keep it under one bucket, that is one index. So different organization units within a big organization, they'll have their own index. Okay, all those things tomorrow practically I'll show it on the query while writing the query. Okay. For today, just remember till this extent, whatever the timestamp and the system name, I means the host name and the process type and the process ID and the system message. Okay, all these things you remember. Okay, got it, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, tomorrow we'll see severity, all those things, criticality, all those things from tomorrow onwards we'll see. So that is the thing. Okay, let's see how it goes tomorrow. That's all for today from my side. Let me stop here.